Okay, so the next thing to do is you guys have proposed projects on the HackNet page. Some of you have proposed a couple of projects. So some of you might have come in right now with a couple of project ideas in mind. So what we're going to do right now is, if you have anything in mind, just come in front and present it so that the others can understand what you guys want to work on through the night, and you probably can tell them if that's going to be possible or comment on it, basically.
Everything's possible.
Yes, everything is possible. So yeah, if you guys have any ideas in mind, just come forward and talk about it. Then after that, we'll sort of take a break for tea and snacks, during which we'll sort of team up. And then after that, we get into the hack night as such. So.
What was that?
Yeah.
You're not supposed to see that. Avert your eyes.
So these are the proposed projects, as you can see. So any of you here who have proposed a project over here? Please come forward and talk about it.
Hello, I'm Devjeet from Vasanji Torres Technologies. My project is about, this is a front end for NoSQL data stores. During this Hack Night event, we're just going to create a simple, very simple app, which will list all the servers, and you basically click on the servers and get to know your databases, whatever databases are there, and then you can see your collections and documents and edit that document, and that's it. That's about it for this Hack Night, but eventually we might add more features into it, like introducing a local host tunnel, web tunnel, basically, just like how BrowserStack does. It will allow us to host that project somewhere, and we're going to open source it in the future once it's really working. And the good thing about the local host tunnel will be it will be hosted somewhere, and anyone can connect it, and use the create a connect tunnel local host tunnel, and use the underlying whatever NoSQL data store that you have, and connect with it. And basically manage your data. That's the whole. That's the whole point of it. Yep.
Thanks. Cool.
Thanks.
Okay. Thanks. Anyone else with the project over here?
Yeah, we've got those. But can you just refresh the page?
Can you refresh the page? Something come up?
Bit startup.
Is that yours? Okay, let's come forward.
It's not a clone that uses Bitcoins. So,
okay. Come on, the camera is on the same.
There are people on the internet can see. No, I swear to God, look, they've got webcams and stuff.
Okay. So, basically.
Hello. Yeah, so I'm Kaustubh Sinkar, and I'm a Ruby on Rails programmer. All the JS guys will not be. You might not respect me much, but that's fine. I haven't done Node before, but I want to do Node. I want to try it out, and I'll be working on this. There was this. MOOC, this online course on Coursera. So it actually uses Node, and this is the project that they ask you to do. So I will be doing this just to see how I can use Node and how it is different from the stock Rails thing that I usually do. I want to see the difference, and that this is what I'll be working on. It's all open source, no such issues. It's on GitHub and everything. So that's it.
Special. Thank you.
Cool. Anyone else? We see a lot of projects over here. Who proposed all this?
Okay. Start calling names.
Yeah, I mean, they should know that. Vishal, Malu. Okay. Why didn't you raise your hand?
I'm Vishal. I'll be working on creating a RSS reader using Node. I'm a big fan of RSS and I use it like every day, but Google decided to kill Google Reader. Now I'm using Feedly, but I'm trying to make my something of my own. So if Feedly decides to kill itself, I'll have something. And
it's a noble aim.
Yeah. also, I think Node.js is perfect for this because you need to query all the websites and pass their XML. And I also plan to use some NoSQL database, so I can store, I will have the cache of all the fields. So that's my plan about this project.
Sounds good.
Let's go to the next one.
Radio.
Is that you?
Okay. So, have you ever paired before? Have you ever listened to music while pairing? That's basically the idea. The idea is have a radio that you can, the whole team can upload the music and they can listen to the music at the same time. So, that's basically the idea.
Who's next? Manish Mishra. Everyone's shy today. What's happening?
Maybe we should spike the coffee.
You have a couple of projects from us, actually.
Yes, I'm Manish Mishra from Sava. And I have proposed three projects. Basically, I'm very new to Node.js. I'm very eager to know whether different business use cases can be handled by Node.js or not. So all of them are just ideas. So I will not be working, might not be working on any of them, but I would like to know whether those are possible in Node.js or not.
Sure.
I hope it is possible because if we can create the HTTP server, then we can create.
You already seen it, right?
Yeah. That is already there. But there are some two different projects as well. I would like to go there. Sending the bulk SMSs. This one. So, yeah, we normally use the bulk SMS system. We can send to multiple persons. So if somebody is registered to our system and we want to create a small system in just a small period of time, is it possible by using that Node.js?
Do you have an API?
Sorry? As of now, I'm not able to access those APIs. There are some public APIs, but is there any library or something like that available in Node.js so that this type of system can be created? Or for creating this, we need to create a separate library?
Well, I think it depends, right? I mean, if you're accessing somebody else's web API to send SMSs, then obviously it's very possible with Node.
Okay.
If you're planning on sending SMSs directly from a modem or something, then you're going to need a driver for that.
Okay.
So if it's hardware, then obviously you need a driver for it. One of the problems with Node is that you need to make drivers, right? So
okay.
Now it's fairly, I would say, mature in that sense. But if there's no direct way to connect to whatever device you want to send SMSs from, it's really harder.
Okay.
Yeah.
It comes up as a TTY, so you can just write to it.
If that's the case, then totally easy. Yeah.
Like, just write TT commands.
So we're going to like Bluetooth pair to a phone and start sending SMSs to all sorts of people.
Yeah, so if you pair Bluetooth, then you have Bluetooth serial, then your serial thing will come out.
That's a good point. Yeah, you can do that
too. Then just like, which device
I use? I don't think he has a specific device in mind. I think he's just basically saying, can I do this? Because this is a problem that he has somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is not specifically related to, you are connected to modem or something.
It's totally like illegal to do this in any case, but.
Okay. This one is related to something showing the some sales related data or something that is very positioning, global positions related data on the map. I have mentioned two cases I think here. That is, if you want to show the different customers with their addresses on a map for some company, like if we will zoom out, then we will start getting the more data from the map related to those customers. So that is the one use case. Another one, in the title I have mentioned that if we want to measure the speed of any driver of truck in transport industry, then and we want to just find fetch the reports out of them. This is a very complex use case, business use case. Is it possible using the Node.js?
It's not that complicated either, right? I mean, you just have to calculate distance travel.
Sorry?
You have to calculate distance travel and stuff, right? I mean, it's not that.
So,
you probably do that in the browser by itself these days.
Because I am very new, I am not aware of the Node.js, so I just wanted to know that whether these type of libraries, some kind of libraries are there, so that we can just pull up that data and show it on UI, you know, just without putting extra effort or much effort on it. Is it possible that we should do it everything using the MongoDB and all?
I mean, MongoDB and Node.js do two different things. Right?
Yeah, so agree. So at the back end, we can use anything.
Yeah, I mean, as far as it's just a basic web application. Anything major. Obviously, Node can do it. At least that aspect of it.
Okay.
Getting the GPS data. There are some devices that can run a Node server. I don't know if that's the best way of doing it though. I mean, probably you need to have an Android app or something to get that stuff. Or even a web page could do it, right? I mean, you could have use the geolocation API and get that from just normal web browser.
So can these Node.js libraries communicate with the geolocation API?
Geolocation APIs? It would depend where's the source coming from, like where's that data coming from?
Okay.
Like if it's coming from a device, then the device has to communicate with Node, that's totally possible. You could send it over JSON or whatever.
That can be communicated easily.
Fantastic.
Certainly, this kind of information will be coming from some kind of devices.
Yeah, I don't think that's a problem. I don't know how you would be able to do this in a hack mode. I mean,
whenever I was just putting this project, I have just put it the idea. I am not working on it.
Sure. So I was
eager to know that whether this kind of application can be done in Node.js or not.
Sure. As to whether it's something that we can
That's what. That's why I have just mentioned that I will not be working. These are just ideas which I would like to know the answer for them.
Right. Sure.
Thank you.
Who's next?
Optimizer. I am Tushar. I would like to propose a small tool to send to it, which will be seen maximum, such as it will be calculated based upon your followers when they are active the most, or when they tweet. A graph will be generated so that you would know when to tweet. It would be helpful for marketing guys.
So you're basically listening to all the tweets that are coming from your followers, when they're online or when they're active. At that point in time,
I will be just calculating based upon their previous tweets,
right,
created
frequency
area.
Frequency of tweets, right?
Yeah, yeah, frequency.
Yeah, I know. You can do it.
Yeah.
Nice idea.
Excellent. Who's next?
Node Twitter. So this is an existing project.
Hello guys. My name is Vidi. Earlier I worked on a POC. It's a Twitter clone that I wrote using Node Express and Mongo. It was really basic. I mean, you could just tweet and add comments, follow users and favorite a tweet, but it wasn't like full-fledged. So I want to add some more features in it and probably fix some bugs. So let's see how it goes. It's up on GitHub, so check out the source.
Oh, this is me.
All right, so
this project is something that, so I, what I wanted to do was, we've got the conference coming up in what, 2 weeks? 2 weeks. 2 weeks in Bangalore. JS4. And that's coming up in Bangalore. And what I wanted to do was build something that we can use at the conference for conference attendees that are sitting in the same auditorium. So what I thought of was, what if we could have all the participants communicate directly over this chat platform or whatever, which is really, really simple to do with Node, as you can see from the stuff that I demoed. But have it be like location aware, so it knows where you're sitting in the auditorium. So have like a graphical representation of the auditorium. And when you say something, it's like a speech bubble that shows up on top of your head. So you can have some context in terms of, you know, where that person is that's typing that out, so it's not completely anonymous. You can add stuff like, you know, what his Twitter handle is and stuff like that, so you know who to follow. And I don't know how much time we'll have, but if we do have the time, then I'd love to have it also somehow stream the slides and live stream video. So you can kind of just sit over there and watch the video, watch the presentation deck, and the comments that are happening from the community, along with where they came from in the auditorium.
Can I make a suggestion?
Sure.
So you're doing everything that's fine, but in the chat server thing,
yeah.
Instead of building your chat server from scratch, it would be better if you can connect to the, maybe write a server which connects to the IRC channel.
Cool.
Because then it becomes kind of a double thing, you know, and like people are already using IRC.
Right.
So, means of course have the video thing, the audio thing, but if we can have the chat connecting to the IRC, that would be like really.
Yeah, that would be awesome. Instead, and then add the metadata about like the auditorium stuff at the node level.
Yeah,
right.
And then it's a build up.
Yeah, that'll work.
Instead of doing reinventing the wheel.
Yeah, that's cool. That's a good idea. Yeah. So what I'm saying is that like we have a hash in memory, right? That'll keep that information about where you're sitting, based on like who's logged into the chat server locally, and. Only those people will get shown on the thing. And we'll probably have like a... yeah, exactly, like that guy, you know, go whack him, you know, that's what I want. I want that kind of thing. And maybe if they give us their Twitter handle, then we can also pull their tweets in. If they have like the hashtag for JSFoo, and have those also show up on their head. Because then it'll give it some context, right? Otherwise, like, tweets are happening out in the dark and we really don't know about them. All right, so that's my one proposal for tonight. Awesome. I think that was the first one. We'll get back to it.
Someone has had a brainwave.
I proposed the project at the very last minute, so if you click the...
Yeah, going back.
So this one?
Yeah.
It's meant to solve a real-world problem that we're facing in a project right now. So we've got a site that we want to annotate, we want to share notes with others, we want to store notes in some backend, toggle them public or private. I mean, let's say it's kind of a book, let's say it's one of the epics that you want to annotate and you know, derive your own meaning from some of those lines. So you want to annotate it for yourself or for others, and you have the ability to share them,
right,
and even tweet them going forward and share them on social networks. We'll be happy if anybody wants to join. Thanks.
I think everyone
will. Well, I guess that's it. Or is there anyone else who suddenly had an idea? Yes.
Last minute.
Guys, my name is Nitesh, and when I was thinking what I had to do tonight, I come up with, actually one of my friends was telling me this cool idea that something like eBay, where people actually buy something, buy through money, instead of you buying through money, people can actually exchange stuff. So I have a stuff, someone else has some other stuff, we both can actually exchange. So I think this is the right time I could actually build some sort of prototype or spike it out. If anyone wants to share with me, that's fine.
Cool. Someone else? Is that all?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So a couple of things about the Acnide itself. So upstairs over there, we have, I should be saying this, we have mattresses over there.
Ooh.
So if you guys want to take a nap when you're really tired or something, you guys can go over there and chill. And we have an open pantry just behind the screen, actually. So you can have tea, coffee, snacks and stuff all through the day, and juice and things are there inside the fridge if you want to have something to drink. So yeah, let's break for tea right now, and you guys...
We are open all night.
Yeah, we're open all night, yes. Yes.
Both without saying.
Yeah. It's a hack night, come on. Should be obvious. So yeah, let's break for the night. No, not the night, for tea. And Paras is one of the mentors, so he'll be around. Catch up with him and talk to him about your project ideas and stuff. And Vishal is the other mentor, so make sure we get the most out of these two people. And also, one more person is on his way, Rakesh Pai. So he'll be crashing the party soon, and also get all of him. So I'll probably announce when he comes back. You also are a mentor? Okay.
I'm not a Node.js person, but you have general computer problems, you can ask me.
Kiran Janulgata. Cool, so let's break for tea right now. We'll catch up later then.